First, I would like to talk about what is quality. Say, as I mentioned, that engineering optimization is very common in industries. What is design optimization? Using this numerical example, if you want to maximize Y, and Y is a function of variable X, and this variable X has some constraint, either inequality constraint like G of X or equality constraint like H of X. And this variable X has to be within certain design space. So you want to search the value X in such a way Y could be minimized. Let's using this one as an example. Say this is a truss example, truss design. And this truss has to sustain certain load F over here. And you need to design this truss in such a way that it can sustain load F, but the weight of this truss is minimized. There are some constraints, like the width. The width of the bridge, the truss, the structure has to be 12 millimeter, and the height has to be smaller than 3 meters. So this is a very typical design optimization problem. This bridge, the weight of the bridge, is very well defined. However, in typical engineering optimization, there are several changes make this optimization more difficult. First one is the model is not always variable. So you don't know the numerical models, so you have to use experiment to find out their relationship. Just like you want to climb to a mountain in a very dark night. And in this case, you don't have a GPS. So you don't have the map, you don't have the system. And you don't have visual because it's very dark. You can only see very limited visual information. So what you have is some surrounding information, just like what you see in the wood, and also maybe the previous experience when you walk come to here. You need to use try and error to find out the direction to the top of the mountain. So it will be very challenging. And also, the system could be highly nonlinear. When you climb the mountain, the initial point will become very important. Assume you are climbing from the right side. You might go to this local optimum, and you thought you're already in the top of the mountain. However, there's an actual optimum in the farther side over there. So for a highly nonlinear system, you are very likely to trap to a local optimum. As I mentioned that you don't have a model, so you need to use experiment. And the experiment will be very expensive. For example, the experiment could be a very complicated simulation. It will be very time consuming. Or you need to use actual experiment, like a car crash experiments. And each crash will cost a lot of money too. So you would like to minimize the number of samples. So this is the challenge you need to face. Next, there will be some errors associated with each design variables. In engineering systems, each variable might stand for some physical dimensions or material properties. And when you put into production, there will be some manufacturing tolerances. And these tolerances will affect your output. Your output will not be a very clear number. It will be a distribution. So you need to think about what is the statistical distribution of your performance, and then find the best design. Number five, you need to consider both performance and conformance. What is performance? What is conformance? Using this archery example, say performance is you can shoot at the target. But conformance is when you shoot a lot of times, for example, 10 times, all your arrows will go to the target, which is conformance. Sometimes you don't have a good performance, but you have a good performance, I mean, conformance. Like the one on the upper right, over here. This figure, this result, you can see your arrows are very concentrated to a certain point. You lost your performance, because your errors is not at the target, but you got a pretty good conformance. But in some case, if you have something in the lower case, you don't have a good performance, and your conformance may not be good either. So you will run into troubles. Certainly, we would like to all our design to be right at the target. This is the purpose of our optimizations. So the last one is constraints. When you do design, there will be some constraint. Like when you climb a mountains, you need to be within certain fence. And you want to find the top of the mountain within this fence. So when you're within the design boundary, you need to consider reliability issue, because every variable will have tolerances. So you need to make sure when the tolerance happens, your design still will be a feasible design. What is quality? There's experts in 20th centuries in quality management, Mr. Duran. He gave a very clear definition for quality. The first part of quality is a product's features, which is a characteristics attractive to the customer. Second is the conformance, as shown in the transparency. It is the ability to consistently deliver on-target performance, no matter what kind of operating conditions, and has to throughout its intentional life, and without any harmful effects. This is a definition from Duran. And I check out the definition in Wikipedia, and they divided this quality into 8 dimensions. Performance. What is performance? It is a product's primary operating characteristics, which are measurable attribute. I give you an example. When you buy a cell phone or you buy a notebook, you first want to compare what is the processing speed. So here is a comparison for various CPU for your cell phone. Some is faster, some is slower. Certainly, this is one of the major performance that a consumer will care of. He wants to find out which one will be the fastest. So this is the first quality. The second quality called features. In addition to the performance, features are some additional characteristics that will enhance the appeal of the product or service to the user. Other than just the major performance, when you buy a cell phone, there might be some other feature. For example, you can take pictures. It can be used as a camera. So camera is a feature. What else? In this cell phone, it not only has a camera, but it has a 3D camera. It allows you to shoot 3D images. So this is another feature. Although the main function of a cell phone is phone, but here features will enhance the quality of this product. The third dimension for quality is reliability. Once it is a product, the user will expect this product will last to the intended product life cycle. So reliability is the likelihood that the product will not fail within a specific time period, which is the life cycle. So reliability is also a very important dimension for quality. The next one is conformance. Although you provide a lot of performance, a lot of features, but conformance is the precisions that the product or the service can meet the specified standards. So your performance in your catalog is something like this one. So conformance is will expect your output to deliver the same performance throughout the product life cycle and throughout your all product line. Next one is durability. How long your product can be used, which is the length of product's life cycle. Using a rechargeable battery as an example, say a better quality batteries, we will expect it can be used for a longer time. Say the first one, the green one over there, that has a more charging cycles, it can last for a longer time, which means that the green batteries has a better quality. This is durability. Next one is serviceability. Once it is a product, there's a chance the product will be out of order under some circumstance. So serviceability is the speed with which the product can be put into service when it is brought down. It can very fastly identify where the problem is and easily to fix it. For example, you have a car, something broke down and it cannot run. So the serviceability is how fast you can identify where the problem is and how fast you can take out the out of order part and replace a functional part and to make the whole product become normally function again. Next dimension is aesthetics. Aesthetics is the subjective dimension, which means that you look something which is very beautiful. Therefore, you will think it will have a better quality. Say, a very beautiful, well-designed mouth, although the function is still the same for a typical standard mouse. But the appearance of this design will increase the quality of your product. The last one is called perceived quality, which is the quality attribute to a good or surface based on indirect measures. It's not a very measurable quality. It is something that feel that the personal feeling for this product. Let me give you an example. This is a polo shirt. You can easily buy that in the internet. And it costs about 600 NT. Looks very nice t-shirt. I'm sorry, polo shirt. Here's another polo shirt. It will cost 4,600, almost 8 times of the previous polo shirt. Looks very similar. What is the difference? This is the difference. A very well-known nice logo on your left chest. Once the person see the logo on your shirt, he will perceive some higher quality or some pressures for your products. So this is something that the name brand has established. So when someone uses this product, he will feel very satisfied. He will feel very happy. This is called perceived quality. So what is the qualities? I would like to add something to that, because cost is a very important factor will affect a customer's feeling about quality. I think quality is not a very distinct, clear, measurable number. It will be a function of the cost. What do I mean? It will be a function of cost. Say, once you buy something, for example, a car. This is a very reliable Toyota car. It costs about 600,000 NT. This is a very good quality car. So when you buy this car, well, you are pretty happy. This is a dream car for most people. BMW 7 Series. Okay, nice car. When you buy a car like that, you pay almost 10 times as previous model. So when you measure the performance of this car, BMW 7, will you use the same standard as the Toyota Vios? I don't think so. You look very carefully and look at all the details. So even though the performance is way above Vios, but you probably can still feel unsatisfied for this product because you have higher expectation for this product, since it is more expensive. So that's the reason why I say quality is a function of cost. So what is quality? I give a very overall general definition for quality. Quality is the difference between the customer's expected performance of the product. then compare with the exact performance of the product. If the actual performance exceeds the expected performance, then this is good quality. However, if the output, the actual performance is lower than the expectation, you will think this is bad quality. So sometimes people will complain some minor details of BMW. Say, well, quality is supposed to be better because the expectation is very high, way high. So it is very important to find out what is the expectations. So you need to design something with the performance higher than the expectation without increasing the cost. Because when you increase the cost, the expectation will be higher too. So how are we going to do that? I will explain the concept, the methods, and some numerical tools using Excel in the following units.